That's right, we found them. The mother lode of all tuna schools. This should have been the trip where we got limits, made history, became rock stars, but did not. We got one. Stay tuned. Let's talk about what I would have done different and how I found them. You already know. Let's go. Welcome back to another episode of Hustle and Fish. Gonna pause for a second, ask you guys to please like, and if you find value in the content I'm giving you guys today, by all means, please share. And if you're on YouTube, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just know, I'm not trying to become no YouTuber, guys. I ain't trying to get popular out here. I have a gut feeling, if I keep talking about fish, I'll be able to do it more. Okay, we got the word, fish were biting, big fish were biting at the corner, right in the corner of Mexican waters and US waters. And we took off with no hesitation. You already know, TTG. Upon getting to the corner, a few boats are out there, but no fish. So we started to patrol the area, making little zigzags, circles, and just patrol the perimeter, as you should do. Nothing showed up. Was no birds in sight, was no life in sight. We did come across a patty, did throw on a few yellowtail, but that's not what we were there for. We were there to get some big tuna. So after patrolling the area for an hour or two, I was like, you know what, let's go further south. So hit spot number one, hit spot number two, hit spot number three, spot number four, spot number five. And I was like, man, just working these areas and nothing. And this was already about 4 hours in. So I was like, okay, I know of another section of spots that is deep south. I'm talking deep south, almost by Ensenada. And I just made the decision, you know what, guys, get comfortable. We're about to go 30 knots and we're about to head deep south on a Hail Mary. Anyways, to get right to it, guys, we ran over a moving school. So I'm driving, I would say within five minutes of that first crash, the kite got hit on a drift. What ended up happening was about 40 minutes later, we got this fish on deck. Deep down inside, like, I knew this was the spot. I knew it was barely about 4 o'clock. I knew we were in the prime area. We had plenty of frozen flyers. We had the perfect crew. It was just, in my mind, I was already celebrating. This is the trip. This is the one I've been waiting for. It was just out of nowhere. The wind started to die, and not just start to die. I mean, the wind completely died on us. And me being in the moment of, let's focus on this kite. Let's try to get this kite to work. I wasted about an hour on a kite, trying to get it to flow with the wind that wasn't there. So I finally said, you know what, screw the kite. Let's just focus on balloons. So as you already know, balloons are good when the wind is low, but I'm talking about it went to zero wind. The balloon was right on top of our head. So as you come home and you reflect, like, man, you're happy you got one, but you already know, man, you could have killed it. And then, you know, you start to settle thoughts, start to think, you know, There's more options than the frozen flyer. Yes, the frozen flyer is our go-to. It has the best record of biggest fish caught on the West Coast. It is the go-to. But if the wind is dead and the balloon is straight up on top of your head, you need to get out of that mindset. Okay, frozen flyer is done. We're not working the balloon. These cows are biting sardines. So after having a little team meeting, we should have launched some flatline sardines up high. We should have put some torpedoes and went mid-range. We should have thrown some flat falls. I mean, you see how big the school was. We might have just got lucky and just snagged one. There were so many. But, you know, guys, I'm not here because I'm the best fisherman. I'm still a student of the game. I'm just here because I love fishing. So anyways, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for watching. Hustle and Fish, you already know. Let's go. So, a little behind the scenes footage. I'm done filming today's episode of Hustle and Fish. I'm about to make my way into the studio and edit this, get it ready to drop on Saturday, 12 o'clock, and enjoy my weekend. No fishing for me this weekend because they're really not biting, and I'm really not seeing or hearing about the dope that I want to see before I pull the trigger and do a trip. So, gonna enjoy my Saturday. Who knows, maybe some home projects, maybe work on some designs, maybe work on some clothing. It's non-stop over here at Ahcor Offshore, but give you guys a little walk through the warehouse, let you guys know what I do on my off time. On my off time, guys, I'm full-blown taking orders, fulfilling orders, screen printing, doing direct garment, doing sublimation, working on a bunch of cool fishing designs for the fall, and a big show here on the West Coast called Fred Hall. Hopefully this year, this coronavirus will be gone. We're in the middle right now of engineering some performance long sleeves. We're in the middle of engineering some dope shorts. We're in the middle of engineering some dope pants. Everything that I need for when I'm fishing. And what I need, we all need, guys. So keep an eye out for a Ahcor Offshore. Maybe we got some cool things coming. Thanks for hanging out. Hustle and Fish, you already know. Let's go.